Hello, my name's Paisley. Welcome back to my Dark Souls 3 Let's Play. When we left off, we were exploring the swamp there, and I just came back, just got some, got my my next level in prayer there, so now I should be able to use that heal. I actually haven't put it on yet, but I will right after this. But I also bought some more arrows. Now I have fire arrows equipped on my R2, so I got a little bit more diversity. And, now we should, I have an item to give to the Pyromancer dude, so I might as well do that right now.
Ah, there you are, Unkindled One. I am pleased to have a pupil as dedicated as you.
Give Pyromancer tomb.
Yes, here we are. It's been long indeed. With this, I can teach you more sophisticated pyromancies. Splendid. I can boast I am your tutor a little longer.
So let's see here, what did we get? Bursting fireball, hurl a bursting fireball, cool. Yeah, these all have lore as well. But profuse sweat, awesome. I can't remember if I read through the lore of these. Oh well, no worries.
If you seek pyromancy tomes, take this sage advice. The lands of the lords converge upon Luthric. The home of pyromancy's drifts comparatively close as well. At least, that is what pyromancers of the Great Swamp believe. The place is called Izalith. Oh, how I wish to behold a primal pyromancy. Well, these are old tales. No one knows where the truth begins or ends. If you seek part the lab at the
So he talks about Izalith, which is the one of the locations from Dark Souls 1. And it's also the witches of Izalith. They tried to create a new flame when the flame started to die out in Dark Souls 1. And in their process they created chaos, which is an uncontrollable demon, essentially. He's the reason of chaos is the reason of that, like, that giant, demon that we fought with Siegmeyer. The reason why they exist is because of chaos. But anyway, actually, before we go back just yet, I'm going to do a quick look at the items we got, because we got quite a bit, and I don't want to start stacking here, so I didn't... Wow, I'm the worst. I didn't actually clean up my inventory either. But we got the Sellsword Twin Blades. Paired scimitars used by certain sellswords. The scimitar's sharp blades make for effective slashing attacks, but fare poorly against metal armor and tough scale-covered hides. With a scimitar in each hand, the wielder can vary their onslaught with unique left-hand attacks when in proper stance. Spin Slash slides into flows with a large spinning motion, and continues spinning in transition into a strong attack. Awesome. So yeah, it looks like what I thought is true, where you... They changed the way dual wielding works in this game, where now instead of power stance, they made just specific items designed for dual wielding, which is cool. I do like that. I don't know if it's better, but it definitely is a way of doing it. Black Knight Greatsword. Ultra Greatsword wielded by the Black Knights who wander the lands, designed to face chaos demons. The Black Knights constantly face foes larger than themselves, and this sword's unique attack greatly reduced enemies' poise. Skill Stomp. Use one's weight to lunge forward with a low stance, increase poise, and follow with a crushing strong attack. So, it is also a great sword. I can't use it, obviously, but look at this thing, man. What the hell? But it's got that big launch. And I believe its R2 is a launch as well. It's got a really cool moveset. Big old weapon. And finally, we got the exile. Oh no, we got two more items to look for in the weapons here. Oh, yeah, where's the other one? Right there. So, the Exile Greatsword. Bloodstained Greatsword wielded by one of the watchdogs of Farron who preside over the slumber of fallen warriors. The blade is a reminder of the Exile's past misdeeds. Inhuman strength is required to wield this heaviest of curved greatswords. Skill Spin Slash, slice into foes with a large spinning motion and continue spinning to transition into a strong attack. Awesome, awesome. So, that was this weapon that you saw that dude using. So I believe, oh shit, didn't mean to do that. So, regular, can I, no I can't one hand, but I can two hand. Big slices, big overhead, followed by another overhead, and then R2 on this. This is just more horizontal slices. Now, if I wait for my stamina build back up, and I power stance. Wait, it said do it, and then follow up with an R2. Wow, that's really cool. That seems very hard to do dodge through. What a cool moveset. And finally, Great Club. Wood club fashioned for the branch of a giant tree requires considerable strength to wield. A hard, durable weapon, its weight makes it easier to break the guard of shields. So, skill Warcry. Oh, shit, I already had equipped. So, big old fucking club. And boom! Boom! Essentially, it's just an upgrade to those regular clubs. And I can't even two-hand if that's how freaking much strength you need to wield this thing. Yeah, just standard moveset for the clubs. And Claymore? There we go. I am going to switch this out for the Uchi, because I'm not even using the Firelong Sword, honestly. And I like the Uchi's moveset better, personally, actually. Just from, I got used to using it when that last area, and it seems to be fairly good. But, last but not least, we'll look at the armor set that we've got two of them. Oh no, I think we only got the one. We got the Sellsword Helm, that's right. So, Sellsword Helm. Metal helm interwoven with coarse cloth, able to endure hardships of battle and prolonged light travel. It's light considering the build, striking a fine balance between absorption and substance. So it's kind of like a little middle ground. Let's see what the stats compared. It's a little less, but we're losing 3.6 just under 3% weight. So that's not bad. Let's see, where is it? Sellsword armor. Metal armor interwoven with coarse cloth, able to endure hardships of battle and prolonged travel. It is light. We already read that. Let's see. Sellsword gauntlets. Metal gauntlets interwoven with coarse cloth, able to endure hardships. Same description. And these cloth trousers and leather boots are of no real note, but are durable and allow for easy movement, able to endure the hardships of battle and prolonged travel. I just realized I'm overweight now. Is the Uchi that heavy? I guess it is. That's unfortunate. Shit. Well, we might have to throw some points into Vitality eventually. Maybe with the extra levels we'll get. I did notice I actually end up dying in between here. I'll put the heal on. Oops, shit. Didn't mean to do that. I actually end up dying. I had walked away to go do something else. And while I was gone, I guess I got invaded and they got a free kill on me, so I ended up having to use another ember, but not the biggest deal in the world. Great arrow. So, Road of Sacrifices. Let's see. We'll go to the left side here and kill these dudes really quick. Ah! He beat me to it. Holy shit. I'm gonna fucking die to these guys if I'm not careful. There we go. Let's test out the heal! Yeah, it's pretty good, and it's also an area of effect. It does use more mana, but it's definitely a bigger heal. Yeah, that's almost an Estus flask, and you get 2 uses per mana flask, so it's I essentially just gained 4 Estus by gaining 2 faith points. So that's definitely better. I don't need to go there anymore. So let's see what's in here first. Oh fuck. Damn it. Big old dude. Shooting magic and shit. I like his hat. Looking for a little nooks and crannies to hide some items. Potentially a chest, maybe? I haven't actually come across any illusory walls yet. Heretic staff. This looks like a safe enough place. Let's see what that is. Catalyst used by generations of heretic sorcerers. Sorcery is a logical academic discipline, and the power of sorcery depends heavily on the caster's intelligence. Steady chant boosts the strength of sorceries for a very short period, works well equipped in either hand. Cool. These dudes. Oh, that dude looks straight up. You alright? Looks like he's not doing very good. Really? Nothing, man. They're fooling me. They're fooling me with their item placements. So now we're on that bridge above. Which actually, you know what? Can I reach you here? Is there anything I should be watching for? There's two of them. I might be able to almost kill them if I do like this though. Oops. Gotta get out of here. Well, son of a gun. At least that's not the worst death I could have done. But holy crap, man. I'm just screwing up my rolls is all. let's just completely skip those guys and go over this way. Hopefully they don't see me. No, I'm golden. And I'll just lure this guy naturally. Oh, that was a kind of a panic roll a little bit, but it worked out. And one more. There we go. Not too bad. After I kill this other dude here, I'll, Oh, I forgot to give, Andre. There we go. Now I'll use another ember. I've got six. They definitely have, haven't been... Oh, look at that. Perfect. Oh, that guy almost fell. Is he gonna fall down on me now? Yeah. They definitely don't give you as much ember. Oh, perfect. Another Estus. That's always handy. Good thing I came this way first. So now I have another excuse to go talk to Andre, because I got that coal, which I haven't looked at either. Oops. Shit, there's just so much stuff to look at! But... Feren coal enable heavy, sharp, and poison infusion. A coal used for weapon infusion. Long ago used to forge the great swords of the Undead Legion of Feren. Give to the blacksmith in the shrine to allow the use of gems for heavy, sharp, and poison infusion. Cool. Let us progress now. Oh! I heard another dude. Are you healing? No. You can't heal. That didn't help you at all, anyway. Crystal lizard. What's over here? Whoa. I almost one hit him. Okay, let's go get that crystal lizard, screw it. Crystal gem, awesome. Well, not exactly awesome if it's what I think it is, but it'll be useful to see if maybe we can get a little lore from it. So this is for making crystal weapons. Ooh, where'd it go? There it is. Infused to create crystal weapon, yep. A gem of infused titanite introduced by Lothric by the Crystal Sages. Used in infusion to create crystal weapons. Crystal weapons inflict magic damage, scale heavily with intelligence. So they changed it, that's good. Because in the past games, crystal was kind of useless. Or in Dark Souls 1, I should say, because it wasn't even in Dark Souls 2. But in Dark Souls 1, if you imbued a weapon with crystal, you lost the ability to repair it, but it dealt more damage. So it was essentially a one-off weapon. Once it was broken, it was broken. You're fucked. Just kind of suck balls. As you can probably tell. Oh, that's a magic. Wow! That was a big old soul spear. I'm kind of safe here. I'm trying to lure this dude. Switch my longsword. Damn it. I'm hiding in the corner. There we go. Unnecessary or unintended plunging attack, but whatever, it worked. Yeah, I took out the longsword there to break that dude's shield. I forgot that is kind of very useful that the longsword can do it. Do that, but this looks like the way out. Maybe there's an item though. Well, I mean, worst case scenario, I can just run back. Yeah, there is an item. Perfect. Ring of Sacrifice, another one. Awesome. Another one. Okay, we ended up over here now. Oh, okay. So this is just another entrance into the same area. Actually, I'm gonna use one more heal. Oh, I can't. That sucks. I'm fine. Ooh. There we go. Ew, I need to get upstairs again. Oh no! Oh no! Oh fuck me. Yeah, I don't really want to fight that dude just right now. Holy fuck, this is not good. I'm just aggroing everything right now. I gotta run into this little hole. Bring me back. Alrighty. I'm just gonna go ahead and use this. And then do one of these. Actually, I'm gonna use two of these. So that's a lot better of a heal. It takes longer to cast, but I'm not gonna be battle casting that heal spell anyway. So I'm back up. Or no, this is still ground floor, never mind. But now I know there's a hole there. I won't fall in it this time. Oh, there's a summon sign for Egan of Egan, we got a name. I wonder if that means there's a boss here. I'll summon the NPC, maybe. Just to show it off. There we go. Done and done. Perfect. Alrighty. There's another summon sign. I wonder if that means there's a boss coming up here. Yeah, that looks like a boss arena, considering there's like, but considering there's like every summer sign and under the sun right now, right there, I'm assuming that that is, in fact, the boss. Which also means that there must be an alternative way to get up there that I don't see. I mean, I'm ready to fight the boss at this point, but I don't want to just rush right into it just yet. What's this? Oh. Oh, here we go. This is what I was looking for. Oh, awesome. An NPC. Wasn't expecting that. Just right around. I don't see anything over here, but let's go take a look. There's... Oh, yes, that's right. There's this item right here. Blue bug pellet? Okay. Interesting. Let's be cheeky. Ah! No, that wasn't... There's literally zero risk for what I just did, but... Let's see what you have to say.
Well, this is unexpected. I don't often have visitors. What do you want? This is my study that you've happened upon. If you haven't any business, I've reading to get back to.
Asked to learn sorceries.
How intriguing. You'd better not. Sorcery is not for everyone. And should never be forced. You have your own methods. Sorcery need not be one of them. Don't let it bother you. Be on your way then. You're unkindled. Shouldn't you get back to your duty?
Okay, interesting. So, this, I'm assuming, is the... Well, I mean, we asked him to learn sorcery, so... But he is the Tier 2 sorcery spell teacher. Don't know if there's a Tier 3 or not, but he's the Tier 2. So, and because I don't have a high enough sorcery level, because I haven't been training sorceries, I don't plan on using magic that much in this game, if at all. So, he will not give us any more dialogue than that, unfortunately. But, it's not the worst loss in the world. Like, it's just one character we won't be able to get dialogue out of for sure in this playthrough. But, you know what? I think I'm gonna go ahead and... Some of this dude... I know about that basement area. I'm going to check out what that is. Plus, there is this down in this hole. I kind of just ran out of there. I didn't really take a look around. But I'm going to summon this buddy. This guy. Because he's our buddy. There he is. Perfect. So yeah, this is the dude that was sitting outside of the jail cell, keeping that person quote-unquote protected. He seems to want to help us, which seems like, okay, then that means he must be a good... That pathing. It must mean he is a good guy, right? But, nah, that doesn't necessarily mean he's a good guy. There's another NPC... Oh... I just got invaded. Well, he's unfortunately, we're gonna gank him, regardless of whether he wants to be ganked or not. Honestly, what am I doing? If I walk into the boss fight, do you wanna... I'm not too sure. You know what, screw it. I'll get invaded another time. Let's fight this boss. Is this gonna go through? Oh shit. You can hit me. What is these magics? Oh. There he is. Awesome, awesome. Yeah, so it seems like the main thing in this fight that I gotta have to do is just stay close. I wanna get as close to him as possible, as fast as possible. So it's kind of just finding out where he is, dodging his spells, and then hitting them if I can. Where are you? Awesome. Once you deal, well, that was cool. Once you do a threshold of damage to him, it seems that he disappears. There he is. Whoa, what the hell? Oh, no. Okay, there's multiple of them. This is bad. He's the one shooting the blue-purple spells, I think, though. Yes. No, don't die. Perfect. Okay, so he's creating doubles of himself that are shooting the regular sorceries, not the crystal ones, though. So we just kind of have to wait to see. That's him over there. Oh. Wasn't expecting a melee attack. Ooh! Too close for comfort. Aww. That's unfortunate. That really sucks. Actually. Son of a fuck. Honestly, he was kind of... He served as a good decoy for the other... Like, the clones. Son of a bitch, that was my first death onto a boss, though. At least I made it pretty far in. I mean, what is this episode? Like, what, 16 or something like that? So, not the worst, but I'll be back once I'm at the boss again. Hello, welcome back. Let's try to kill this guy now. I'll try not to die this time. I wish I... You know what? Why the hell am I not using a buff? I'm a hotkey a buff really quick. Let's see here. Should we lightning or... We'll use charcoal. Sure. So let's do that really quick. And go on through to the other side. Yeah, I two hit for 400, but I'll take that. He needs to hurry up so I can hurt him. That's not too bad. 700. We're doing alright. Let's see. Aha! Well, this one's going a little bit better. I'm still not dead. Oh, sneaky fuck. Where is he? What's up there? Ah! I couldn't get to him in time. He's in the back, I think. Yep. Oh shit. Fuck, I didn't mean to kick there. Oh, he used SS, perfect. I was getting worrying about him. Oh, there he is. Where are you now? I was surprised when he used the melee attack there. Didn't think he would use melee. There you are. Ooh, I don't know how that didn't hit me. Almost. One more round of this. I should got him. I should have him, I mean. Let's see, where are you? Oh, you're in the back corner! There we go! Haha! Not too bad. Hair of Fire destroyed. Soul of a Crystal Sage. Awesome. Thanks for the help there, buddy. Now, I think this is progress, honestly. I think I just beat the bosses of the area. So I'm gonna go check out what's downstairs there. Unfortunately, it's gonna have to be at the start of the next episode because we're running out of time, but... that's alright. We beat a boss. I feel like we accomplished a little bit. So yeah, well, we'll go see what's downstairs there on the next episode, as well as I'll go put a point into... I think I'm gonna do endurance with this next point. And yeah, first death to a boss, and it's on this dude when he had like 3 hits left on him, of course. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next episode.